Hi Kati, welcome to Goa 365. And first of all, before we start, I would like to ask you, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Okay. Basically, first of all, how is the lockdown treating you so far?
It's been going well because I'm staying at home only. As like it's good for the family, so we're spending a lot of time. As before, we used to go most of the time to play and all. I'm at home only. So it's good for the family and for me as well.
Okay. So, for another, I have to say congratulations twice for you. First of all, you are become a father of two beautiful angels. And also, you have signed a contract once again with Hyderabad FC for the upcoming season of Hero Indian Super League. What was the most exciting thing for you when it comes to the two good news
that you have? I can say that when I got the news and I got two baby girls, I was very happy. And like that is the most important moment of my life. And I was like, I don't know how to, I was emotional also. And I was happy also that and I held them, both of them, in my hands. And later on, like when they came home,
yeah.
And like every day is like a beautiful day for us.
Yes.
And later on, I got a news from Hyderabad that they want to sign me, and and on that I got double you can say double happiness.
Yes, I think because even on social media, that video where you were, I mean that picture where you were catching your kids in your arms went super viral. I think even I came to know personally on that photo, and then I think I gave you a call and messaged also about it. So coming back, how is the double happiness going on at home, especially now you have more extra activities to do at home also, right? Because before it was just sports for you, but now also you are playing a major responsibility. You have a big responsibility when it comes to becoming a father. So now it's become like super big. So how is it?
It's good. Like when we start a day, like we are with the babies only. Like we need to feed them. The day goes like like we get less time for ourselves, and like whatever time we get, we try to give for fitness and rest all the time for the baby. And it's good. It's going good.
Yes. It's, as you said, it is all going good. And you also said that you had a double bonanza of news, because one side, you came to know that you became a father of two little angels over there, and then you also signed for Hyderabad FC. So how was it in this point of time getting two big good news of your career and in your life?
I think like when my wife delivered, I think it was after that, after 1 week, I got news from Hyderabad that they want to sign me. And then I think 31st May or some first, I think first June they announced, I think so. So it was a good, good news for me that like after when I got two beautiful my babies, and then this news.
Yes. So, how is the fans reacting to you and your family members reacting when it comes to you signing for Hyderabad FC?
I think it's important for me that I need to play wherever it is in any club. So, I know that last season I was with Hyderabad, and I never thought like I should not sign. When they offered me a contract, I said, okay, I need to play. So, and I was happy there last season, and I know the club and the situation over there. So it was easy for me to sign there, and family is there always supporting me wherever I want to play.
Yes.
And it was good for me to sign over there.
And basically now, especially you have been in football from right from your early age. You have been a part of Dempos, then you have gone for Kashmir, then you have also been a part of Mumbai, and then you went came back to FC Goa, and now with Hyderabad. So how do you rate yourself when it comes to your journey? Because we have seen that you have been in almost in every part, and being in the senior team as well, and you have brought lots of laurels in your name as well, and also for the state of Goa. So how do you see your future when it comes to Hyderabad FC now in this year of ISL?
So many years I played football, and I played different clubs and different levels. So it's a new challenge for me next season, as like Hyderabad are trying to rebuild a team, and they're signing good players. hope like yes. We have a good season next season with coach Roca, and hopefully we'll try to aim for top four and in semis.
Yes. Last year, in the previous season of the ISL, we have seen that Hyderabad FC has not created that much of impact when it comes to their gameplay or even in standings of the ISL table. But we have seen that you personally have given one of your finest performances right even at Fathoda in Goa, also in Kerala, or when it comes even that one match against Calcutta and against Delhi, Odisha, was something, a big achievement, because we have seen that you have given, though the team didn't perform well, but you have given some of the finest performance, and it was said to be that one of your good performance of last season. So how was those kind of matches, in spite of team not being at the top, but you personally have given some of your finest performances for those matches? So what will be your take on that?
I can say that I was waiting for a chance. The team was not doing so well, and I think we were too open while playing. We are too open, so we are giving a lot of space for the team to score goals, and we considered a lot of goals. And when I got chance, I played a match against Kerala. It was not that great match for me, but when I got chance, second chance, then I started playing good, and that time the team was set, we are playing with our plans, and I can say that in those games I improved a lot, and we played good and we got some result, but it was too late for us to come up off the table. And I can say personally for me it was a confidence booster. So it gave me a lot of confidence to I played after a long time because I was injured for some time, and then after a long time I came and I gave some good performance. So it's good for me to carry on for next season and try and build on that.
As you said, it was a good boost for you. But how was that boosting when it comes to during the lockdown? Because the lockdown was such a period which actually drained everyone, and it actually somewhat demotivated also. But I think you were more motivated. So how was that lockdown period, which is ongoing lockdown period, when it comes to football for you, and when it comes to your pre-season or some activities for the upcoming season of ISL?
I can say that COVID-19 made life a little bit difficult for everyone. Only thing I can say that it's good for us to be at home. I can only say that people to be at home, no need to come out. If you have something, you can come out. And for me, it's the same thing. I be most of the time be at home only. And I have whatever equipment to train at home. I do gym and at home only. It's good for me to keep my fitness whenever I get time, and it's been last 3 months good for me. I was doing my gym regularly and keeping myself fit, so it's not late for us to do our fitness and then be ready for the next season.
I said you're all set ready for the next season, but I would like to question you with regards, what do you feel about the football in today's era? Because there are lots of youngsters who are looking to come up in the field of football. There are other sports as well, but they see more light, more fame, more atmosphere, a larger organic kind of a circumference where they can fit in, which they can make their career. So what do you feel when it comes to football in today's era?
I can say in India, whenever I think 2014 when ISL started, from that year, football started growing in India. And players started getting fame, and then fans started coming for the matches, and then it started growing. From that year to now, we can say that the stadiums are very full.
Okay. When it comes to support, you how was your journey when you entered into football? What was your support? What was the lacking or some advantages that you went through when you started off your journey?
I can say that in my family nobody knows about football. One of my PT sir, Jude Barreto, he took me for trials at Vasco Sports Club, and he gave me chance to play for school also. So from there on, I picked football, and I was given chance in my school match, and as a goalkeeper, I played very good. And there one, my PT sir, Jude Barreto, gave me a life in football, you can say. When we start, when I played for FC Goa, we were in Dempos. So it was like half season I League and half season ISL. And that time, I think we signed from Dempos only, as the owner was Dempo, sir.
Srinivas Dempo, yes.
And And it was good for us. Like, first season, I got only two matches. And second, third season, I played a lot of matches. So then and now, like, it was a long journey. So hopefully, I want to play more and keep moving forward.
Yes, coming back when it comes to ISL, I think we can go on and on when it comes to football with you, because you have seen some of, you have also played for some of the best leagues in India in your career. So when it comes to ISL, there are lots of Goan budding talents who have signed, who are going to make their debut in this season or with ISL, right from in different teams across in the all 10 teams of ISL. So, what will be your advice for them, because they are going to start their career off in ISL?
First of all, I'm very happy for them. Like, in Goa, right now, the only one I-League club is there. And difficult for the Goan players to be noticed by other ISL clubs. But whatever, like, Goan got some contacts in the ISL club. Only thing I want to tell them that whenever you'll get chance, give your best. Keep working hard. Like, you'll be the stars of Indian football in future. So just keep working hard.
Yeah. On that note, on working hard, we have seen that you also are like the most hardworking player, because I have personally seen you also when it comes in your season, because I used to come to visit all of you guys. So I have seen that it was more of professionalism for his time to time, a proper diet, a proper health routine, a proper sleep. So how is it that it is for you in your real life and in your professional life as well?
It's the same. Like, I want to keep it simple, whatever it is. I want to give some time for my family also, for myself also, and for fitness also, for football also. So I keep it simple. So whatever the time is for the thing, I want to do that. So it keeps me fit every time, all season, if I do the proper things.
So, Kati, I would like to ask you more with regards to football in Goa, because Northeast areas are supposed to be said as the hub of football, okay, because there are lots of budding talents. Like, they say that every house has a player over there, but in Kerala also it's the same thing. But in Goa, they say that every ward, if not the house, every ward has a beautiful player and a talented player. So what do you feel about the Goan talent when it comes to sports?
I can say that, like, in Goa, the talent is a lot. I mean, the players are very talented. The only thing, like, they come at certain age and they disappear. So I want to tell the players, just take the talent and keep moving forward, so that somebody will notice you someday and you'll get a club. When you get a club, be professional. Keep your mind towards the football and, like, try to learn whatever you get, and then you will be in a good team and you'll have a good future.
Do you think that once they come in, they get the fame or they get that the lots of fan following and that factor, that X factor in them, which actually, and then it hits their brain or it hits their success, and then they try to come out of it or they do extra. Do you think that is happening too much in nowadays football or any other sports, not only football?
It's up to the individual, like, how he takes. If he takes, like, social media is like, with social media, you want to be famous. It's not the right way. It's good for you to use it, but you should keep it simple. Football aside, social media aside. And try to, like, keep yourself more in football if you want to be a big player and try to play for India as well.
Yeah, when it comes to social media, we have personally, I have seen your profile also. There's no much of social media. What is that? Do you hate social media? You don't like coming on social media?
Nothing. Okay. I just want to keep it simple.
Okay. It's that simple that you like, okay, I'll just come, and just post once in a while. That's more than enough.
At least
now you are active, I can say, on social media during the lockdown or even during your free time. But when it comes to during the league time, it's hardly anything.
Hardly, no, nothing.
So, it's the same. Go on. I can continue later. Go on.
It's the same, whole season, same. I come to get some news on Insta and all, and then that's it. If I want to post something, I post, and if not,
yeah. As you said, social, what is that one app that you use frequently or your finger goes to open that app? Which is that one or two apps that you always, besides WhatsApp, what is the other two apps that you use frequently?
I use Insta.
In this lockdown period, there were lots of, because everything is shut, the gyms are shut, the sports complexes are shut, everything is shut. More and more people, youngsters especially, even the adults, but youngsters have opted for cycling, jogging, then going on the beach for a run or a swim, or even playing football on the beach and in the field. So what is your quote on that? Because suddenly the sale of cycle has boosted like whoop, and then everyone has opted for cycling. So what is your quote on that? What would you say on that?
I think people were, for a long time, they were in the house only. So they wanted to come out badly. So whenever they went, like, lockdown was opened, they like took the cycles, they went out, they wanted to do what they wanted to do, and they did cycling, running, whatever they want. Mm. I think I can say that they should be a little safe. That's it.
Yeah. So I think maintaining going through the protocols and as per the guidelines, I think you can be safe. So coming back to, besides, you said you were busy at home because you had your extra and good a broader family now. So, but besides that, how was your lockdown? Besides the family, spending time with home, how was the lockdown for you especially?
It was good. Like in lockdown, like you can do a lot of household work. Like you want to do something, repair or whatever, you get, like you want to open it and check and again try to fit, make it. And
like other football stars or other sports persons, did you personally opt for like cooking or kind of something? Because everyone tried to make something new. So, because I personally also, I think, was more into like cooking than at home, working from home. And so, how was that for you? Did you opt for something like that?
Yeah, cooking and everything, like, it's normal for me. Like, whenever I get time, I feel like to cook for myself. And because when you make something healthy, you need, or you only need, nobody else will eat. So, in night house, I want normal food.
Kati, now let's come to the serious part. When it comes to football, we have seen that many of the leagues have been cancelled, right from the FIFA, right from the Premier League, to everything is delayed. Even the national games in Goa have been delayed. So do you think that there are some, I think even you follow the Premier League and the English League as well, because there are lots of matches that which are already started, but they are all happening under closed doors. So what do you think, do you think ISL will start with a big bang like how it was before, or do you think it will lesser the number or it will be closures? What do you think about, forget ISL, what do you feel about the other tournaments, upcoming tournaments? Because there were massive number of, right from Olympics to hockey to the cricket to football and different national as well as international sports or events that have been cancelled or even postponed because of the ongoing crisis. So what will be your quote on that?
I think it's better to we take some time for it. I mean, it's COVID. It's not a small.
Yeah.
I can say it's been a a big problem for everyone.
Massive. Yeah.
So I think we should give some time for it, and like whenever it's like comes down, then we can start. I think on all the sports, like fans will be coming less now because COVID thing. So let's see, hope and wait when this will get over, and then again the like the season will start like before.
Kati, you are in the you also live in Vasco, right? So, and Vasco, there are news coming up of cases being on a high rate now, increasing day by day, like 30, 40 increasing day. It's almost, I think today's count is almost like 200 plus. So how was that reaction for you? Because you come in that area and you have that, all of a sudden that comfort zone has gone into a panic for you. So what is going on in your mind when it comes to your area of, and there are rising cases there?
It was a shocking news for us, and then scary news, as we stay very close to Mangur. And like we've been going to Vasco many times. Like, well, if you want something, we go Vasco only. So when we got the news, like it was a scary news for us. And like from then, from our family, nobody wants to go to Vasco. So I think we need to take care of ourselves, and like other people also should take care of themselves. And it's not best thing to go out.
It's not a So I think we are more discussing on lockdown. I should cut down lockdown and come back to football. So Kati, how was your experience playing with Hyderabad FC last season?
It was a good experience for me, and like I enjoyed playing in Hyderabad. It's a good place, and like the management was is good. They're very helpful whenever like I know we didn't give good results, but they were always supportive. The fans also are very good. They always support. You lose or you win, they were always behind you. And I enjoyed a lot my last season. Hopefully, coming season also I'll enjoy.
Yeah. So coming back, coming season, you said you will enjoy. So what are the things that you're looking forward to the upcoming season with Hyderabad FC this season?
We need to try to be in top four, nothing less than that. As this year, the team will be a rebuild, and I know that the team will be good. So we need to come together and work hard and try to be in top four.
You guys are getting BFC's former leader, that is Albert Roca. So how do you see him as a leader and a guidance for you when it comes, or a mentor for you for the upcoming season?
End of the last season, he had come to Hyderabad. He was with us for some time, and we got to know that he's a very good coach. When he came, like he taught us some things that made us a good team at the end of the season, and we got some results. So I know with under him, we'll perform good, and we'll be a good team this season.
Could you share some of the best memories of you right on the field and off the field, even in the dressing room or in the hotel or in the room? Some memories that you would share about yourself and with your teammates or with the team at large of last year's season for you with Hyderabad?
I can say that the last match we played against Northeast, it was like the team was very happy the way we played. And we knew that it was coming. As we played against Bengaluru, we played very good. The coaches were very happy. So after that, we knew that it's coming. And then we played against Northeast, we won 5-1. And that was the happiest moment for the team.
And some of the moments that you would share off the field that you remember, like, and you actually laugh, or like the most precious moments, something like that.
There were some moments like when we used to train, we used to have some fun games, and whenever the things used to not happen, and when we watched the video later on, we were like laughing like anything.
So what do you feel about the new talents, right, from Goa, not only from Goa, there are lots of even new signings that even Hyderabad is doing or other teams are doing. Hyderabad have been already gone ahead of new signings. So what is your thing when it comes to the new signing and the new fresh team that you will see with Hyderabad FC?
I think when we are there in end of the season, we knew that they are trying to sign some young players from Indian Arrows, and we knew that the players are very good. They are talented, and I think they need like this 1-2 years. They'll be like the future of Indian football, and it's good for the team. Like there is experience and youth as well.
There were, we also came across the news wherein lots of players from Hyderabad FC have been released. So, what would you like to comment on that, or what would be your say on that?
I can't say anything as it's their choice. Like they want to move forward and try to play some other clubs. And
What will be your message for those guys who are there with the team and those who are not as well?
The players which are with us and with Hyderabad FC, let's work hard together as a team and try to do something coming season, and hopefully and who are gone, all and, the best for them and good luck.
So I think I have already crossed my time because I think I can go on and on, but I would like, I always have this thing before I end where I ask you your message for the upcoming talent, for the people who are going to come in support of you, and also those fans in Hyderabad that follow you.
I can say only the young players, just keep working hard. Without hard work, you will nothing will get. So just try to keep yourself motivated while playing football. Yeah, you can see many great Indian players. Try to follow them. Try to learn from them, and you'll be a there so soon.
Yes.
And for the
tell me. Yes.
For the fans, Hyderabad fans, like I can say, just keep supporting us. That's it.
Yes. I think on that note, I will come to an end of this wonderful discussion. I think there was some. I think even I didn't realize when the time went so fast. But thank you so much. It was amazing speaking to you. I wish you all the very best. Good luck, and once again, congratulations. And stay safe, stay blessed, much love, God bless.
Thank you. Thank you so much.